What is up, you guys? 404 Bros back again with another video. Here we are with video number 2. Thank you for everybody that's staying tuned and tuning in. Like I said, try my best to bring out more content. So next J video every Tuesday. Subscribe, stay tuned, and if you already did, thank you so much. So it was a little bit of a long minute, but worth the wait in my opinion. Jeep turned out amazing. I guess you guys want to see it for yourself. So let's go ahead and see how the Jeep is looking after the frame shop and all the repairs so far that's been made. Let's go. Whoop, and there she is, finally back home. And I won't be doing too much talking because I got a bunch of content that I'm trying to squeeze into this video and don't want this video to be super long. So here we go. This is the part he was working on. Got this frame rail nice and straight again. Look at that end right over there, straight as an arrow. Here's this little view and angle. It's perfect. Radiator support, this lower piece got creased over here just a tiny bit. So he pulled that out, straightened it out, and it's back to spec. So measurements are good. All the gaps are good in the front. I'll show you guys that at the end. Let's just move along. So after that impact, all this kind of shifted. This fender kind of was scraping this door. So not no more. Door is aligned. Gap is good. Also, this door was sagging, so he fixed that for me as well. Perfect closing. And yeah, this side on the driver's side, no damage at all. All it needs is just a little wash. And boom, here's the other portion, the tailgate. If you guys remember, this was pushed in. Couldn't really call it a dent because it was just kind of with this impact that I guess happened either during the impact of this front end collision or maybe just some time in its prior history. But honestly, could have keep it how it was, but decided to just fix it. So all it needs is just a little bit of Bondo and repainting, and that should be good. And last but not least, if you guys remember, there's some deep scratches over here on the driver's side. All that got fixed. We're not gonna have to put a bunch of Bondo like some of it guys like to do. They say the thicker the better, but not in the Bondo case because it will just come off. So here we are, looking good and straight. Overall, I'm just super happy. Like, the body of this Jeep, even though it was in a collision, is just super straight, super nice, and couldn't be much more happier than I am. And if you didn't tell already, but this fender actually is a new fender. It is aftermarket because couldn't find one, honestly, in pick and pull. Every fender that I would see was for the 95 and older, I believe. Couldn't find anything 96 and up with the facelift like mine. So I went and got an aftermarket one. It is Kappa certified. If you guys don't know what that is, I recommend paying up the extra 20, 30 bucks per part. You get a much better fitment part. And just in general, the stamp layout of your part, say fender hood, is going to be better. So therefore, the fitment will be better. So that's that. The gist of the damage. I guess I'll close the hood and you guys could see the gaps on the front end. Oop, and there's the front end. Let's go ahead and check out them gaps, boy. Check that out. Nice and wide for you. Nice and even on this side. Let's go ahead and check out the other opposite side. Boom. Same exact nice gap. And I was just messing around. The gaps are not that wide. And also this part, forgot to mention, he did actually touch up for me. As you could see, banged it out a little bit. But yeah, there you guys have it. Same thing. I could repaint this hood or not. But I guess I will repaint it because I've seen these little scratches, and they're pretty deep, and that's the only part of the paint that actually looks like that. Like, the fender is fine, but then once you go on the hood, I don't know, something happened where it got scratched, so I will be repainting that as well. This nose panel right over here is aftermarket, just wanted to add. The body lines match up perfectly with the panel. That's not the issue, but there's a slight little issue, I guess. Something happened when I did receive this part. It had this little scratch right over here, and now you can see this part is kind of sagging a bit. But I mean, YOLO, I could keep it like this, or maybe if I find a cheap one, because that's the issue. I couldn't really find a used one that was not damaged and the same time at a decent price. So that's that for now. All right, there you guys go. Job is finally done on day number two. You know how we like to do our things. You know, come check the silicone. Still not dry. So we go, you know, back home, take a little nap. And, you know, wake up, come back, check on the silicone again, see if we could proceed further. Oh, you know, it's still not fully dry. So, you know, you just go back on the computer, look at some, come back to the silicone. No, I'm just messing with you guys. That's not what happened. What happened was my silicone that I had, three tubes, all of them were dried up. So last night, all the stores were closed. Couldn't get any silicone. So today we got some silicone. Finally finished this job up. So that's that. And the next thing that we're going to do is probably remove this front header panel and all the little areas that need touch-up paint work. After the frame guy, you know, did his thing, there is a couple bare metal areas. I don't know if you could see, but you guys probably seen already. We're going to touch those up so we don't have rust in the future. I got a spray can at AutoZone. I think the paint code is PAG or PGA, something like that. Forest green on this Jeep. And yeah, we're going to do that and probably slap on the radiator next after that. So let's go ahead and have some fun. Moment of truth, everything is installed. Now let's see if we have any leaks, so let's go. Alright, so I was hoping I wouldn't hear any abnormal noises, but we definitely have something kind of weird. I don't know if you guys could tell with the camera mic, but it seems like it's coming from the bottom of the engine in the front more than the top, but I could be mistaken. I'm not sure. So I don't know. I think what I'm going to do is fill the car, remove the drive belt, and see if the noise is still present. Alright, so here we are. Drive belt is removed, and I'm going to start it up real quick to see if the noise is still there. Let's see what happens. Alright, we're in neutral. Here we go. I still hear that noise. Uh-oh. You definitely hear it. Wonder if that's harmonic balancer has something to do with it. She is shaking a bit down there. I don't know if you could tell. Welcome back, guys. Straight to the point. Last we left off with the XJ. The engine was making this ticking noise. Kind of sounded like a rod knock possibly, or some bottom end noise. I was kind of fearing the worst, obviously, after something like this happening. So called up my brother from another mother, Roman. He came through, called him Master Tech for no reason. He revved it, I listened. I revved it, he listened. And we kind of agreed upon popping that timing cover. And once we did, check out what we found. Whoop, and there it is, that timing chain cover. So what we did, popped it off immediately. Master Tech Roman, as I like to call him. Boom. Immediately spotted this timing chain guide. There's one little piece somehow sitting here, and that was it. So the timing chain started slapping against this piece on the timing cover, causing that ticking noise. So boom, he spotted it. Respect for that. And I'm happy it's nothing crazy. As you can see, here's the other piece, the new one. much more malleable. So we're gonna pop it into position how it should be. I already replaced this timing front cover, front seal, and added some silicone around the edge, so it's good to go. And since we only seen like two little pieces, and there is this little gap inside the oil pan and the timing cover, so most likely the rest of the timing chain guide is inside the oil pan. So since it's already kind of seeping, and decided to drop the oil pan, better to be safe than sorry, maybe fish some of the other pieces out, and at the same time reseal the oil pan. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm not gonna replace the sprockets or the chain. It looks fine to me. There's nothing abnormal there. The only thing is this tensioner is a little bit weak, so we're gonna replace it. And here's that gasket for the oil pan. So let's go ahead and start. Have some fun. Alright, so here we are back in the garage. Here's the oil pan, all nice and clean, sparkling as it should. Here's the opposite side, all nice and clean. We got no gunk up in there. So here's that old gasket for the oil pan. I do have a new one right over here. And also, here's the flywheel cover, all clean. And I forgot to mention, I did get harmonic balancer new one, just because mine was starting to wobble a tiny bit. So I'm not gonna record the whole process of I put everything together, so I'm just gonna slap everything on, and the next thing you guys will see is hopefully this Jeep pretty much front end assembled and me trying to crank it up to see if there's a noise. So here we go. Alright you guys, so right off the bat, this 2.5 liter is purring. Sounds much better. There's no more of that clicking, ticking noise. Much quieter, even on the cold start, as you can hear right now. So it should quiet down a little bit, and obviously after I drive maybe 100 miles, it'll get even better. But we got fresh oil, no more ticking noise, very nice.
So here we are meeting again with the XJ, and I guess this might be the last, this will probably be the last piece of content in this video. So if you guys made it this far in the video, still watching, still staying tuned, didn't exit out of the video, please subscribe to the channel, give your boy a like, it does help out the algorithm. And last but not least, give your boy some input, a comment, a suggestion, all that above, because I do read all of them, and all the suggestions I do need, because it's my first XJ build, never had an SUV, anything four-wheel drive, don't know much about axles or anything, so everything is much appreciated, so thank you.
So there you guys have it. Headlights are installed. That's the main thing I was waiting for. I'm pretty sure you guys were too. Super happy with the beam. It's pretty bright and it's not too blue. So I'll drop a link in the comment section or in the description of the video. You guys could see they're not super expensive. I don't know, 80 or 100 bucks. Can't remember. But they do have the same version. It looks pretty much the same, exact, but it's like on the major like Jeep websites, and it's probably like $200-$300 or $400. I don't know, but these are way cheaper, but it's the similar look to those. Anyways, header panel is installed, but we did run into a little issue. Can't install these reflectors because header panel came bare with nothing, and I'm missing these little plastic things where the screw sits. So I need to find them on Amazon or somewhere, maybe some AutoZone or Eileen's has it, I'm not sure, but I'll try to do some research. I don't even know what they're called, and we'll go from there. Other than that, this video is done. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and stay tuned for the next one. It's going to be next Tuesday. We're going to be getting this car repainted. I should say Jeep. Jeep repainted. It's going to be all in one color. I'm probably going to repaint the hood as well because there's light scratches on it, because I kind of want this thing looking pretty smooth. So we got a headliner issue that's, you know, pretty common on these XJs that we got to repair. We're going to finally drive it, do start registration, all of that, because I don't want to tow this thing around anymore and waste money on that. And obviously trying to find a tow truck can be hard. But other than that, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and stay tuned next Tuesday for the next one. We out.